So now let me show you how you can subscribe to two different observables at the same time. This is actually easier than what you might think. So as you learned, an observable is a stream of asynchronous data that arrives over time. Now, instead of having two separate subscriptions to these two observables, we want to combine these observables into a new observable, and then we'll subscribe to that observable. Okay? So back in our GitHub followers component, on the top, I'm going to import observable from rxjs/observable. I'm also going to import one of the factory methods for combining multiple observables. So import rxjs, add observable, and the name of the factory method is combineLatest. So this factory method, as you learn in the section about consuming HTTP services, this is a static method on the observable class. We can use this to create a new observable, and then we'll subscribe to that observable, okay? So back in ng on init, I'm gonna call observable.combineLatest. Now here we pass an array of different observables. What is the first observable? That is this.route.param.map. That's an observable, right? Now, what is the second observable? That is this.route.query.param.map. So now we can combine these two observables, and as a result, we'll get a new observable. And then we can subscribe to this one, okay? Or we don't actually have to store the result in a separate variable. We can make this code cleaner and shorter. So we can immediately subscribe to the result. Now here we need to pass an arrow function just like how we subscribe to a simple observable. So let's say combined goes to, so here combined is an array with two elements. The first element is the latest param map object, and the second element is the latest query param map object. So if I type combined of 0 dot, look, here we have a param map object, and this is the object that is coming from the first observable or the first string. So here we can get all the required parameters. Let's say ID. Now in this particular example, we don't have an ID passed to the followers page, but if you have a page that has both the required and optional query parameters, this is how you can get access to all these parameters. So let's store this here in a variable called ID. And now if we type combined of 1, look, again, we have a param map object, and this object has come from our query param map observable. And with this, we can get all the optional query parameters, like get page. Now that we have the value for all these parameters, we can use our service to get the data from the server. So our code would look something like this. So this, the service, dot get all. Now here, our get all method doesn't take any parameters, but let's say here we had a parameter, then we would set the values here, like this. Now let me comment this out and delete the other code here and move this line inside our subscription function. So here's the end result. We combine multiple observables. Let's subscribe to that observable and then use our service to get the data from the server. Now here we have a subscribe inside another subscribe, and this looks a little bit ugly. With reactive extensions, we can rewrite this code in a cleaner and more elegant way. And that's what I'm going to show you in the next lecture.